Well, they have got some better stuff than we have seen so far. I think I like it here, and I think I'll hang around until I'm big enough to take on damned super mutants.
Don't move, Synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a Synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes. We're family.
This individual is busy.
Put the gun down now.
He's a Synth. He'll kill us all.
Kyle, no!
Oh, Christ.
Show's over. There are no Synths in Diamond City. Hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Oh, boy. That... I'm not even going to loot that guy. No.
Hey.
Will he talk to me?
You got a gun on me. My own brother.
I know.
What happened?
I'm not a Synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me?
I need a minute.
Well, yeah, you just... watched your brother get his head blown off. Has he got anything? No, I'm not taking anything.
Officer?
Why'd you shoot him?
I need you to step away, Scabber.
Yellow?
Yeah. I understand, officer. I just want to know what happened.
You got bricks for ears? I said get the hell out of here now.
Damn.
What's everyone still standing around for? Go back to your own damn business.
Officer?
Move along.
Okay, then. So we got that newspaper, didn't we? So it should be in here somewhere. Story of the century or something, was it? The synthetic truth. Public Occurrences, October 22, 87. The Synthetic Truth by Piper Wright. Noodles, okay. Noodles, we all eat them. We all love them. And Diamond City's Power Noodles has supplied this substance for the past 15 years. From the stilted mechanical cadence of Takahashi's programmed Japanese to the fragrant steam that wafts from each bowl, to the scalding tang of each delicious mouthful. The ordering and eating of noodles is one of many, say, shared human experiences, or is it? I was struck by this very question as I sat at the counter of Power Noodles last Wednesday night, just after 5 p.m, enjoying a dinner I had so many times before. That's when I noticed our very own mayor, McDowell, sidle up to a stool and engage in the very same ritual. Right hand extending, mouth opening, teeth chewing. Yes, eating noodles, the shared experience of almost every Diamond City resident. So it must have seemed to the residents of Diamond City nearly 60 years ago on an uncharacteristically warm May evening in 2229 as they sat around this very same counter. But that was before the days of Takahashi and his noodles, when the bar served not noodles, but ice-cold Nuka-Colas, frothy beers, and stiff shots of whiskey. The barman's name was Henry, and that night he facilitated the shared human experiences of drinking, smoking, talking, and laughing. That is, until tragedy struck. There aren't many among us who were even old enough to remember that evening, although some of the city's ghoul residents certainly could have, had they not been forcibly removed. Thanks to Mayor Dono's anti-ghoul decree of 2282, but there is one person who does remember distinctly the events that transpired that evening, respected matriarch Houston Hawthorne, who recounted her story in Public Occurrences exclusive interview. I'm not going to do a ghoul voice. Oh, I was there all right, sitting right at the bar, sure as you're sitting in front of me now, 22 years old or so. and just looking to have a good time. I was safe behind the wall. We all were. So what was the harm? And let me tell you that Mr. Carter made it easy. He came up to town earlier that day and said he was from out west. Somewhere. It didn't really matter. What did matter was his smile and his laugh and the way he'd make everyone feel at ease. That night at the bar, we all just sort of crowded around him. Everyone wanted to exchange a word or hear about the state of the Commonwealth. And Mr. Carter, he was all too happy to oblige. It was just so wonderful until it wasn't. Euston continued her account of that evening and the moment when things started to turn sinister and the truth about Mr. Carter was revealed. We'd been drinking and carrying on. Must have been 3 hours. Mr. Carter had 4 or 5 drinks in that time. He seemed a bit drunk. I guess like the rest of us. Then something just sort of happened. He was smiling, but the smile sort of went from his face all in an instant, and then his cheek started twitching. Kind of a funny, and I remember watching him clear as if it happened just yesterday. He reached inside his coat, took out a revolver, and then blam. He shot Henry the barman right in the head. Didn't hesitate, didn't show any emotion. Mr. Carter killed Henry as casually as if he were paying him for a drink. But his cheek never did stop twitching. Let me tell you, all hell broke loose after that. What Euston is describing is, of course, the infamous event known as the Broken Mask, when the people of the Commonwealth learned for the first time the Institute, the shadowy scientific organisation responsible for the creation of combat androids, had actually succeeded in creating a model so advanced it could effortlessly infiltrate human society. Like a Terminator? Maybe? Unbeknownst to the people of Diamond City, the Institute had somehow evolved their androids into true synthetic humans, synths. After he shot Henry, that Mr. Carter shot 3 or 4 other people too. Like I said, all hell broke loose. The guards came running, they opened fire, and Mr. Carter, he kept shooting and throwing people around left and right. Finally, those guards put him down. Seemed like they had killed a man who had flipped his lid, gone crazy. And then he lay there like a dead, crazy man, sure enough. It was horrible. But then we saw the plastic and the metal. This was one of them early synths, you see. And we realised it wasn't a man at all. It was then we all knew. The Institute wasn't just out there. The Institute was everywhere now, among us. It was never determined precisely why the synth known as Mr. Carter went on his killing spree. Some suggested he had somehow been remotely controlled by the Institute, who wanted to test his combat effectiveness against people drunk at a bar. I don't think so. Still, others felt he had simply malfunctioned, a hypothesis supported by the twitching cheek, and was never meant to kill anyone. But that time, the why hardly seemed important. What mattered was that humans of the Commonwealth had been truly infiltrated by an organisation whose intentions and motives were, and still are, a complete mystery. Using a model of synth even less advanced than the ones the Institute has in service today. Which brings us to noodles. Specifically, the noodles consumed by Mayor McDonough. I'll figure out how that's pronounced properly. Last Wednesday night, in the same spot that Mr. Carter the synth went haywire and mercilessly killed several people after spending hours sharing in an experience the people of Diamond City assumed was reserved for members of the human race. They were wrong. Are we? That's actually quite well written. I mean, you know, for a rag.
Ooh. Hey there.
Oh, wait, son. Bottom.
Well, what are you... I thought you were trying to talk to me. Okay. Is it the mask? Is the mask putting people off? Put that back on. It's go with the army helmet. No, put your gun away. I just want to look at... Oh, God, I hate this interface. Same key for mouse look is the same key to use a special attack. Oh, Jesus, what a... Anyway. Right, so it turns out there was a synth. Stealing, can't touch it. Fair enough. So, how does the quest look now? Go to Valentine's Detective Agency. Okay, so they are not that far away. Commonwealth Weaponry, nobody there? I think we probably, yeah, we bought from Percy, we got a new shotgun. Am I going the wrong way? 20, 14. Where is it then? Is it? Oh, is it up on a higher level? Is it a bit like Megaton? How do I get there? Okay, schoolhouse. Detective.
Does anyone fight back? Institute has to have enemies, right?
What? You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale, man. They don't exist.
Now, hey
the
there.
The hell is that newcomer, supposed huh? to mean?
Talk to
You're
Abbott
full of
Wall.
It, and that kind of talk is going to get you snatched up by the synths.
Can you not talk over each other so... See Abbott about the wall. Oh, God. Okay. Let's see our... Actually, no, let's talk to Abbott about the wall before we go and see a detective. We might find... do a bit of a detecting of our own. Where's that one? This is the extended section, I guess. Resident. Another resident. So, okay, we found the detective's pad. I want to talk to somebody else. No, let's not pick any locks. Oh boy, I'm getting confused. Right. It's easy to navigate when there's nothing to see for miles, and then there's a cave or a door or something like that. Okay, so I guess that guy is outside somewhere. Okay. Let's check that out first. So it led us outside. So, oh, is it miles from here? Oh, it is as well. Follow the... Okay, okay. I thought he was inside there. Apparently not. So I guess we're going back in. Institute synths come in a variety of models from the skeletal Gen 1 to the advanced Gen 3, which is indistinguishable from a human. I know we've got Trinity Tower radio, but the problem with Trinity Tower radio is it causes problems.
Oh, wow, you're tall.
Security.
Balance basement. Providing top of the line fashion to Diamond City for over 50.
Okay. Valentine Detective Agency. Okay then.
Luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Oh, Nick.
Okay.
Something wrong?
Oh, forget the bills. Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Don't worry, I can help. Tell me what happened.
How do I know
Nick
I can help?
Working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
No.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
You said Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things. Style and body count.
Okay. All right. Yeah, come
I'll
on.
I'll find him. You have my word.
We'll pick that.
Thank
we'll
you.
Pick up that
Nick
quest
be
as well.
Spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please hurry.
Level up. Oh, it's worth talking to them then. Hold tab to see your purchase. Yes, I will. Now then. What was it I wanted to do? That's the thing. Trying to remember everything. Now, I did want hacker, but survivability, and I wanted that so I can, yeah, you kind of want all of them, that's the thing with it. But I think, where's the lock picker? You can pick expert locks, you can pick master locks. Bobby pins never break. Oh, that's kind of cool. Or medic. I think it's going to be medic. Alright, we get a bit more out of stim packs, etc. Okay, so let's follow the Jewel of the Commonwealth. You've reached level 13. I know. Started Unlikely Valentine. So is that part of the same quest line, or is that... That's Road to Freedom. Jewel of the Commonwealth has now completed. So do I want to find... Yeah, let's go find him. Just gonna... Gamma round. What the hell shoots gamma rounds? Or do they go in different guns? Okay. Didn't have a lot of stuff, did he? Okay. Come on. Down we go, pup. So I'm guessing that guy's going to be outside somewhere. Piper wants me to do a story with her, but I'm not entirely sure that that's something I want to do. Oh, can we pick up some food? Yes, food isn't stealing. What else are we here? Got potatoes, we've got those munfruit, we've got... Anything else we can eat? Nope. Okay. No, all of that is stealing. Okay. What's happening here?
It looks like the mayor's gonna give another speech.
Everybody, I need everyone's attention. I would like to address the subject that is on everyone's mind. And that is the disgusting article Piper has written. Diamond City has stood united for over 150 years. And what keeps us united are two things. First is the great green guardian behind me, the wall.
Our protector
and our savior from the filth of the outside. And second is our faith and trust in each other. The faith and trust that has given us prosperity, security, and education for every citizen. And while the paper might point their fingers at synths and other ghost stories to drive us apart, We will not betray this sacred trust. Now, I want everyone to hear these next words very carefully. I am not a synth. I am the same flesh and blood boy who grew up on these streets, who was born in a shack just down the waterfront to Martha and Patrick McDonough. And I will not abandon my city due to the heinous allegations of the press. God bless this city. God bless the wall.
He's so full of shit.
Yeah. That was just a ton of rhetoric. Guy with the dodgy hair. No, he's not.
You read the paper? Damn synths. Hiding among us.
Don't bother.
Excuse me.
Don't bother, pal. I ain't seen nothing. I ain't heard nothing.
Okay. Thought you were talking to me, in fact, but I'm guessing you're not.
Just leave me alone.
Didn't do anything. Well, if you're going to call me a scabber, I might as well do some scabbing. Right. Okay. So. What's all this sort of malarkey with an upper and lower level? So are these are apartments. And on Kellogg's house. No, let's not do any breaking and entering. Okay, so these were the press boxes, weren't they? And they're now considered an upmarket apartment. Okay. Well, this is hallowed ground, isn't it? This is where the team sits. Security office? Can I? Oh. Well, it didn't come up red, so I'm assuming it's okay to go down here. We've got cells,
do
okay.
Something fun? Run the bases. Trust me.
Hey, officer.
Look, I'm telling you, it ain't just a story. University Point, that settlement on the coast, wiped out by synths.
Okay. Run the points. Well, it would have been the old baseball points, I guess. That's a useful computer you've got there for law enforcement.
You've been to Good Neighbor? Friggin' hall. Ghouls and chem heads all over.
Okay. Got a low opinion of any of everybody, don't we?
Nice.
Are you the
dog.
Same?
Officer.
Oh. You hear about that settlement? Covenant? Nice. Real clean. Strict entrance requirements.
Okay.
Though.
Likes dogs. Read first. Please do not activate this Protectron unit again. The thing has been on the fritz for months now. In case you are new or just ridiculously forgetful, this unit started opening fire on civilians out of nowhere on a routine patrol. No one can fix its targeting procedures, so we are taking it out of rotation indefinitely, and I have no clue why we haven't ripped it apart for scrap, quite frankly. Thank you for your compliance. Okay, let's leave that one alone. I think that's a completely emergency-only situation. And why would it think everybody is a criminal of some description? So this is where the security guys hang out. Sorry, but...
Near Salem. Why would anyone even go there? Been abandoned forever.
Hey, officer.
Don't worry. You're safe from the synths here in Diamond City. I hope.
Well, I was just going to say, I think you're on fire. Looking at all the smoke here. So that would have been an old... car park entrance here, I guess. Yeah, it does look like it, doesn't it?
You
okay.
There's gonna be trouble. Get it?
I'm not about to cause any trouble. I'm just being very curious and what have you. Why am I allowed to walk around your police station? I think I'll leave. Because if I'd have been a synth, you'd all be dead. Gwyneth Beers. Diamond City. Right. I think that's just given us a bunch of quests just from talking to these guys. So we're going to have to start trying to prioritize. Oh my god, we've got how many? Investigate the Museum of Witchcraft. See Abbott at the Wall. Investigate Parson State Insane Asylum. Oh my god. Let's stay with Find Nick Valentine. I think that's probably going to be enough for one day. Oh, hello. What's going on here? They have much curiosity. Mayor. Call elevator. It looks like it's here, so... Okay. They have an elevator. That's pretty cool, actually. Okay, so this is the Haves. This is where the Haves hang out. It's pretty nice in comparison, isn't it, actually? And you can see why they look down on people. Yes, indeed. Okay. So these the Haves. Well, they must feel secure leaving the doors open. Excuse me. There's no way that bronze thing is sat on there. Oh my god, it's a complete giddy-up buttercup.
Far too busy to talk right now. I'm the mayor, after all.
Yeah.
Mayor McDonough?
I have somewhere to be. Sorry.
Fair enough. You have three telephones, and there are no telephone lines. Okay, you're a loony. So this is sort of your office, etc. This stuff on the floor is really good, actually. It's I use it when I'm working on cars and things. Anyway. So what have we got here? Elevator. So where does the actual elevator take us? Oh, that's not making me nervous. Yeah, creepy lift music as well. Bing. Poppy ping.
Gotta keep watch on the gate.
Sure. Not going to stop you. Right, how many millions of miles away is our quest then? So that's fine, Nick. That's not ridiculously far. God, it's night time again. Is there somewhere to sit? Can't just wait while you're standing up. You have to find somewhere to sit. Okay, we had a little look down there anyway, didn't we? So, let's have a look at this map. Right, so... that's right across town. Apparently. And it's the middle of the night. Actually, let's... perhaps we're better going... during the day. Oh, I'll help myself, don't worry. I'll just do this. I'll take it. I am allowed to sit. Can't sit on that. I can sit here. I think where... actually, I'll sit there. Okay, and then we can wait. 2:30 a.m. How did it get to be this time? early alarm call. Morning, everyone. May I safe steal from advance. Oh, I can guarantee you we'll be doing something like that after. So now we can see the full extent of the place. I thought that tower was inside here. It's clearly not. Right, okay. Seems we have a quick way in and out. Or at least sort of. Let me just borrow the mayor's exit. Listen to the fabulous music. Or, you know, maybe not that amazing. Thank you, and I will. Okay, someone running. And still running. Okay. Right, so we need to be heading in this kind of direction. Oh, wow. That's not looking too safe. So we'll have to investigate there for some loot, I think. Now then. Whoa! That's better. Okay then. Maybe we shouldn't come down alleys. You were a lot of help, weren't you? Never mind. It's alright walking around with a gun out. Oh, well done, dog. Ooh, it's quite sort of handy. Got a stove. Living on mongrel, don't it? Mr. Mash. Whiskey. No, it's, they literally do not have a roof over their head. Whoever is there. Is there. Come on. Dog meat, magic yourself through the door. Alright. Okay. Friend or foe, I wonder. This kind of way. Let's just switch out to a bit of that. Okay. Boston Public. Oh, I want to explore the library. There's just so much stuff to look at. But I think what I will do is quite simply heading up. Ooh. Cathedral. That's cool. Am I actually going to end up? They're pretty vicious, aren't they? What is it? Oh, I know what that is. That is a super mutant somewhere. Nice job, dog. However, the hell's shooting? Where from? Ah, shotgun's not hotkeyed. Quickly. That was not that. short, hardened coat. Yes, it was. Short, hardened coat. Q. Slot 2. Okay. Let's just test that quickly. Is that maybe not even shooting at us? Whoa. Good lad. Don't. Oh, come on. Well. You're hurting my dog. That means I don't like you. Gotcha. Okay, we've got a turret, haven't we? Okay, can we get around this turret another way? Ow. There's got to be more of them. Yep. Nothing. Your gun turret just exploded.
Playing games with me, huh?
Kind of. I've no idea where you are. Is that you up there behind the bin?
No sign of him now.
What the fuck was that?
Junk. Revolver. Nope.
This is bullshit.
These voices sound like they're literally right bang next to me. I don't like
getting shook up over nothing.
Maybe.
Payback time, boogeyman.
Okay, where are you then?
Someone's out there.
The hell are these guys? I can hear you. That's not a problem. It's seeing you that I'm having a real problem with. The hell are these guys? Oh, there you are. Frustrated at not being able to see you. Not
clearly doing much damage to her. One more. Yep, gotcha. Now I've got to figure out how to get up there.
Oh,
gun behaving as intended. Whoa. Hell, that got me off guard. Baseball bat, thank you.
Oh, shh.
I'm on fire. I thought my thing wouldn't do that. Okay. Pause for thought. Okay, let's just keep low. Bottle cap, shotgun shell, Molotov. Well, in close proximity fights, this is pretty damn useful. I thought it would be because it rate of fire so much better. It does mean we burn through the ammo quite a bit quicker. Okay, so we're in the bird's nest. He came up there. How do I get over there to loot that one? I go down a level, do I? Is that your handiwork, Dogmeat? Switchblade. Yeah, maybe. Okay, we're either being very brave or very stupid. So what's that rifle she had? Oh. Slightly disappointed now. Glow-sighted diddle-de-der. Probably sell it. Okay. Is there a better one in here? Shotgun. Marksman's cap. Must be worth money. Bottle cap. Lead tempered radar right arm. It's very heavy. Radiation damage I don't need at the moment. Watch me need it later. Okay, let's check up here. Machete, just because it's a machete. Oh. That wasn't us. He's way too far off for that to have been us. We are getting we're getting very badly sidetracked here. But then again, psycho effect. Okay, grab those two. Somewhere to sleep. A bed. Okay. Can we get down there? Yes, we can. Curiosity killed the cat, and it will probably kill us. Okay, let's head up there. That's back where we were before. Okay, so maybe we can't get across to that building from up here. Or can you? No. No, we're not. We're not going to be jumping that distance. That's a whole other... Ooh, not liking it. Yeah, that's a whole other thing getting across to there. Yeah, actually, let's get down. Oh, we're never going to go and find Valentine. He was going to be died of old age by the time we get there. Now, did you have anything of any use? Pipe, revolver, pistol. Not really. No. Loot the scrap. Okay, 99 meters from destination, I think. It just flashed up then. Whether or not that's accurate, I don't know, because it's gone back to not even telling us. Ooh, this is a bit of a blind alley, isn't it? Okay, this would have been far more scary. Whoa! Who's shooting? And from where? Dog found an enemy. Where? Where the heck? Oop. I'm blind. Okay. Where's he gone? Where's that one gone? Oh, no. How's that one? Okay. Still getting shot at from up there. Gotcha. And bits have been landed down here. So where's Legendary Raider then? It's on my screen, but I can't see the mob. Where? Somewhere. Level 14. Ooh. Oh dear. We haven't scratched him yet. Can we get some better cover? Oh, dented him. Don't go up there, dog. Oh god, I'm out of ammo! Oh boy. Okay. Rethink. This is why we bring other weapons. No. Marksman's calibrate. Give it a go. Oh, I've got no bloody ammo for that either. Oh, gold. Give this a bit of a go. Oh god, I've got nearly no chance to hit him. It's not a very accurate weapon. Oh, where's my laser rifle gone? Laser pistol, laser rifle. No, that wasn't it. Charging. Laser rifle, there we go. Go back to the other one. Close, okay, save. Right, so we're out of sniper ammo. Oh, God. Globe. Not going to be taking a globe today. this is a emergency frequency found. Okay, well, sorry, having our own emergency today. Take for the ammo. Oh. That's it. For a mob that tough, that's, you know, not that amazing. DB Technical High School. Yes, I guess I have discovered it. Emergency. Wait till we find it again. We've gone past where we're meant to be going. You're kidding. Well, if I knew what that stood for. Somewhere over that way. I have no idea what that's about. 38 round, stim pack. Quite a nice, but when you're staying here, look, it's nice and clean. Okay, well, so we've overshot where we wanted to go. What the hell ammo do I need, though? It might be a special weapon and highly valuable, but it wasn't very good in that situation. Hardened sniper rifle. 308 ammo. Oh god, I had tons and I sold it. I should have checked. When I modded it, I changed the ammo type. That will teach me. I hope we're following the right thing here. Yes, that's just my unlucky Valentine, yeah.
What the hell was that?
Oh, hell no!
There's not a patch on the other one, but short hunting rifle. Nope. It's only better than the one I'm holding. It's not better than the one I've got. Pipe revolver pistol. What ammo actually used? Where's the body? Well, it didn't vaporize. Oh, there you go. Let's have a look at what you've got. Ammo and junk. There's a lot of radio stations around here, aren't there? Silver. What did it say?
Calling all Silver Shroud fans. I got an urgent mission. If you're a true fan, stop by the Memory Den and to talk to Kent Conley. The Silver Shroud needs you.
Galaxy News Radio.
evil walks the streets of Boston. One man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging.
Kind of glad it was.
Just down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the track.
Yeah, wrong side of the tracks.
I'm just...
I'll listen to that later. That's far too distracting. Boston Common. I hope this isn't going to be a rescue mission, because we just had to rescue ourselves from a car. Not being hostile. Okay. Who's shooting at who? Okay, I'm not sure about putting our gun away. I think probably we will. And then in the meantime, let's drop that there. Okay. Sort of walk-in casual might be, just think possibly might be the way we should go. But we'll see.
I'm telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. We caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that bat of hers in your face until there ain't no face left.
No, they're not friendly. Oh my god.